Okay, so what we are trying to do today is we will run a time series analysis on the data file, which is air passengers. So while doing it, I'll keep on giving you the basic theoretical inputs also. So please follow. Now, this is the data. All of you have this data. See, whenever you are using a data, it's very essential for us to know what the data is. As I always keep telling you, the first thing that we need to do is do a bit of eyeballing. But this was a small data, so I don't need to do the head and all. Okay, I can run the entire data. But anyway, it is always better for me to know what is the structure also. So if I check the structure, then you will be, okay, you get to know what is the structure. This is a time series data. Fine. If I see the class, it will give you the similar thing, class air passengers. Now I get to know this is TS. TS stands for time series. Okay. So I have two commands which I can run. One is that is structure, str. That gives me the entire structure. You can see it gives me, it says it's time series, and from to it gives me the starting date. That is, it starts from 1949 till 1961. Then it starts giving me some values as well. Okay. Likewise, if I ask what is the class, it gives me just a simple thing that it's a time series thing. Okay. So structure is a more elaborate thing, and class is just a, it just gives me what the table stands for. Okay. And then, if you need to know the start date of this time series data, it gives you this start date is 1949 year and one is the month, that is January 1949. End, it gives me the end date, that is 12th, that is December 1960. Okay, frequency, how frequently the data was recorded, that is 12 times, that is in a year 12 times the data was recorded. Okay, cycle, you know the cycle, first month first cycle, second month second cycle. Okay, so you can see in January it's the first cycle, February 2nd, March 3rd. Okay, so these are the basic commands that you need to know for a time series data. Okay, the way we do for any data frame and all, okay, we run the head, we run the tail, all those stuff. So for a time series data, the specific commands that we run and see whether the data is performing well or not, okay, or to know the basic criteria of my time series data, these are some common commands. Okay, so whatever we did up till now, it was just eyeballing the data. So I just demarcated. So these commands are just to know the nature of your data. Clear? And trust me, this is a very, very important step. If you ignore this, many a times you get into trouble, because at the end of the analysis, you get to know this data is not the kind of data that you expected it to be. Okay, if I run all the time series commands on a data frame, you will get very weird results. So I need to know how my data looks like, what is my data, what is the what are the components in my data. Okay, so the first thing, I did my eyeballing. Now the second part of my any kind of a machine learning, you know, algorithm, is you need to have a visual outlook of your data also. Okay, so just we had a structural outlook till now, just see a visual outlook. As I said, it gives me an error, that is figure margins too large, means I kept very less space for it. So now I gave it enough space so it can plot it easily. Now I can have my plot. Okay, now you can see I get a very beautiful time series plotting starting from 1949 extending up till 1960. Fine, I can see the trend, the general trend is an upward trend. Sorry? The AB line is not a time series, it gives you a trend line. Okay, on a plot, if you want to plot a trend line, I use an AB line. Okay, so on this, you can see for all these points, for all these fluctuations, as I see, sometimes if I look at these kind of movements in a stock market data, we call them spark lines. Okay, do you know that we call it spark lines? Sorry? Excel also has spark lines. So, we are not talking about the software, I'm talking about the plotting. Okay, these are called the spark lines. Okay, so if you see these spark lines, what happens is, if I put a trend line, that is connecting all the means of all the points. Okay, it will give me a trend line. Now, for which I would say AB line. Okay, I'm running a regression model, LM, linear modeling. Okay, and air passengers, that is, you can see we usually say Y on X in LM. Okay, in a time series, my data is dependent only on time, nothing else. Okay, I do not have an independent variable, right? We discussed it earlier also. In a time series, we do not have an independent variable. My sales or whatever, it depends only on time, nothing else. Okay, if I know the sales of 2018, I can only have a predictor, the sales figures of 2017 or before it. Okay, I don't have any other predictors. Likewise, for 2019, the sales figures of 2018 could be a predictor, nothing else. Okay, so that is the, you know, special nature of time series analysis. So what I do is, this is my air passengers, this is the data. Okay, this data depends on time. Okay, I just write time and air passengers. If you just see what is time, it will give you nothing but the year names. Okay, but it gives you, it converts it into a data which can be analyzed now. Okay, so just simple Y on X. X is the independent variable. Here my independent variable is nothing but time. My air passengers, number of passengers depend on time, nothing else. Okay, so I plot a line. So I get my trend line. Fine? Makes sense? Now just see. This is the problem. Okay, whenever you have this data like this, okay, like this in the sense, what I mean to say, you can see at every point of time, the variance is changing. At every point, the variance is changing. Now let us see, the variance is the distance of the spark line from the trend line that I have drawn. Okay, now let us see, the distance is this or this. Okay, likewise, this or this. This or this, but if I come over here, the distance kept on increasing. This is nothing but variance. Okay, this is called variance. And when my variance is not standard or stationary, I cannot apply time series. Okay, so the important paramount condition for applying time series is my variance needs to be stationary. Getting the point? Likewise, if I also see my mean. My mean is also increasing. Okay, so I need to make my mean also stationary. So two things I need to do. To run a time series analysis, I have to make my data stationary. What do I mean by making the data stationary? My variance has to be constant. My mean has to be constant. Okay, and here we will apply some mathematics that we have learned earlier. Okay, as I told you, as we progress within this course, the more and more involvement of mathematics will come. Okay, so here, now if I need to, okay, if I need to just remove these things, okay, just moving ahead, I think we did this visualization. Okay, if I just want to plot the general trend, this gives me the general trend. So before doing any kind of an analysis, as I told you, we will have some general trend, we will have some seasonality. So to see a general trend, I just break it down year wise. Okay, I broke this data down year wise and I'm running this, I'm getting a general trend of my data. So it's an upward trend. Likewise, if I need to see the seasonality, the best visualization tool I have is a box plot. Okay, so this is not very essential for my time series analysis, but just to measure the seasonality to get more insight into my data. Okay, when I run this, I just zoom it and show you. Now you can see the data has some seasonality. I can see the passengers are peaking during this months of June, July and August. Okay, the highest being July. Okay, so just you can see it more or less resembles a kind of normal distribution plot. Okay, so this is what seasonality is. Right, now the next step, that as I told you, I need to remove those variances. Okay, I want to make my data stationary. So first I would make my variance constant or my variance stationary. Okay, how will I do that? That's very, very important. To remove the variance, you have to take the log value of the actual values. Okay, when you take the log values, the variance would be removed. Okay, you must have used small little log tables in your school days. Now you have a powerful system which will simplify those things. Okay, now just what I did is log air passenger. Just if I run this part, log air passengers, just write this log air passengers. You can see you get the log values of your data. These are log values. Okay, the entire data is transformed into logarithmic values. Okay, now when I plot the log values, you can see what happens when I plot the log values. What did I do? Okay, yeah. So when I plot these log values, okay, what I tried to do is I removed the variance. Now, if you see, let us say, if I plot this, if I give a name to this and I just plot a line, okay, you can see now the line will run through somewhere here. Okay, now the line will run somewhere in the middle of all, and you can see the fluctuation has become homogeneous. If I compare it with the previous, one second, I'll delete these so that we can have a better comparison. Yes, I want to delete this. Even I want to delete this. Okay, now this is one and this was the other one. You can see the kind of fluctuations this had. Okay, this had minimal fluctuations in the beginning and the sparks started increasing as we approached 1960. Okay, but right now if you see, right now the movement is more smooth, it is homogeneous. Okay, so what we did, we tried to homogenize or standardize or make the variance stationary. Okay, kuch nahi kiya. What we simply did is we simply took the log values of the data and plotted it. First step, we removed the variance. Okay. Abhi humne variance, we have standardized the variance. We have made the variance stationary. Anna, this is this. Okay, it will make the variance equal. Okay. So what we did is first time we removed the variance. Okay. Now the variance becomes stationary. The next step is to make our data stationary. We will on the same thing. What we do is we differentiate. You know differentiation calculus padha hoga, dy by dx. Okay. So now you have to differentiate this data. Okay. And when we differentiate, the mean will also become symmetrical, or what we say, constant. Okay, it will become stationary. Okay, so on the same thing, okay, we have done the same thing. Ye part ka log air passengers, I have just differentiated it and plotted it. Okay, so plot, differentiate, log passengers. Okay, now you can see the if I run a line now, it will run through like this. Okay, even the mean is stationary, and even your variance is stationary. Make sense? See, when it was going like this, mean is also increasing. Okay, when it is like this, mean is constant for everything. Okay, so remember, when I run a time series, very important, my data needs to be stationary. What do I mean by a stationary data? Common or consistent variance. Number two, consistent mean. How will I control the variance? Taking the log values. How will I control the mean? By differentiating the log values. By differentiating the log values. Okay. Just to simplify, see what I did. Let us say, if I create an object, let us say log L, L equals to. Okay. Just I made an object L for the logarithmic values. And if I just differentiate that. Okay. If I just differentiate that. Differentiate L, okay, you will get the same thing. Something missing? What did I do? Let me just, you know, sometimes messing around creates problems. Inverted commas? No, I leave it. I'm not now getting into all those things. You understood, okay? Now I'm not in a mood to do the troubleshooting. Fine. So first thing what we did, we tried to make the data stationary, and then to make the data stationary, two things have to be done. One is control your variance. How do I control it? By taking the log values of your data. Okay. Number two, I have to control my mean. How will I make my mean stationary? By differentiating the log values. Okay. Had these kind of tools not been with us, these things would have been complex. Okay. Abhi aram se just log likh diya, diff likh diya, khatam ho gaya. Okay. Yeah. It has to be a time series. Okay. But I will do it. Don't worry. Okay. See, understanding the concepts is very easy with, very structured data files that we have. Okay. Ye sab learning easy ho jati hai. But after that, when we take some unstructured data sets, जिसके बारे में हमें कुछ नहीं पता, तो यू नो यू विल हैव लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स, बट वी हैव टू डू द ट्रबल शूटिंग, रिफाइन इट, एंड देन बिकॉज दैट्स द रियल वर्ल्ड सिनेरियो. ये तो टेक्स्ट बुक सिनेरियो है. ओके, सो एनीवे, ठीक है. नाउ आई होप यू आर क्लियर अप टिल हियर. सो अप टिल हियर व्हाट वी डिड इज वी हैव जस्ट प्री प्रोसेस्ड आर डेटा. इसको हम डेटा प्री प्रोसेसिंग बोलते हैं. ओके, so we have just pre-processed our data. Fine. Now for time series, there are several models. Okay, there are many models. Many people have proposed different models, and one of the most important model and most widely accepted model is the ARIMA model. Okay, you must have studied ARIMA model. Maybe, I'm not sure, maybe in MGN 604, I'm not sure, maybe. Okay, नहीं पड़ा, कोई बात नहीं. ओके, सो अरिमा इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट पॉपुलर. नाम सुनने में भी अच्छा लग रहा है ना. सो अरिमा इज नथिंग, इट्स जस्ट अ फैंसी नेम गिवन टू समथिंग. ओके, नाउ यूजर्स हैव टू स्प्लिट. नाउ जस्ट अरिमा को समझने के लिए यू हैव टू जस्ट स्प्लिट दिस एंड अंडरस्टैंड वेयर आर वी. ओके, ओके, नाउ यू हैव टू जस्ट स्प्लिट दिस एंड अंडरस्टैंड ए आर I M A. Okay, it is not, don't read it continuously A R I M A. A R space I space M A. A R stands for auto regressive. Okay, A R stands for auto regressive. Okay, and M A at the end stands for moving average. Okay, auto regressive, and at the end you have moving average. ARMA is okay. I stands for integration. Okay, so it is integration of auto regressive moving average. Fine. So see, there is a lot of maths behind this, lot of maths behind this, but I will try to skip upon the deeper elements, and I will just keep the things that are most essential for our learning. Okay, right now if I go into integration and all these, which is not the it is not what we say the required course outcome. Okay, the outcome of this course is not to teach you integration and differentiation, but the outcome of the course is to help you make predictions. Okay, so I will touch upon only that area which is very essential for you, and you have to just either memorize that or take it as a thumb rule. Okay, that will simplify things. If I start digging into it, okay, then we have to bring upon a lot of mathematical concepts which will again kill our time. So I'll touch upon only the vital area. Okay, so just pay attention and try to understand. Now I have these three components in this: AR, I, MA. Okay, when I run these models, okay, from AR I get a value called P value. Okay, from the entire model we have to extract three values: P, I, D. ना सॉरी पीआईडी मेरे को कितनी दिमाग में रह गया सर पीडीक्यू ओके सो वी हैव थ्री वैल्यूज कॉल्ड पीडीक्यू ओके नाउ पी विल बी अ वैल्यू दैट यू गेट फ्रॉम ए आर ओके क्यू इज अ वैल्यू दैट यू गेट फ्रॉम एम ए एंड आई रिमेंबर यू कैन राइट इट लेटर नाउ जस्ट लिसन केयरफुली ओके व्हेन आई रन दिस ए आर पार्ट ओके I will have to calculate or compute the p value. You won't get a p value as an output. You will get a graph. From the graph, you have to sense what could be the p value. Likewise, this ma, from ma, you get this q part for which you have to get a graph. And from the graph, you have to extract that p value, a q value. Okay? Ye dono, aapko koi aisa output nikal ke nahi aayega, graph dekh ke dhoondna padega. Okay, and D part, okay, D, that comes from the I, okay, the D value is the number of times you differentiate your data to make your data or make your mean stationary, okay, yaha in this data I have seen, I differentiated my data once and my mean looked quite good, okay, ek baar mein kai baar na ho sakta hai, it may not happen with the first attempt. Then you have to differentiate the differentiated data once again. Are you getting the thing? You have to keep on differentiating the data till you get a homogeneous mean. So you have to remember how many times did I differentiate. Getting the thing? So let us say, pehli baar differentiate karke D1 kar diya, D2, D3, D4. Let us say it took 4 differentiations to get a constant or stable mean. Then D value would be 4. In our case, D value would be 1. Are you understanding? Okay. So D value is the number of times you had to differentiate to get the mean constant. Okay. To stabilize your mean. Is this part clear? Okay. Now we will require a package, very small little package called T-series. Okay. You will require a small little package called T-series. You have to, if you do not have, please install it and then put it into your library. Okay. Done. Let it happen. Now let us move. Okay. Just observe. You put the package for installation and please observe. Okay. Now the next thing from this package, once I put this package in the library, the next thing we need to do this ACF. Okay. ACF is auto correlation factor. Okay. ACF stands for auto correlation factor. So when I check this, it gives me something like this, okay? Because I run this entire data on non-stationary data. The output that you got, it is on the non-stationary data. That is my original data, okay? So it doesn't give me any clarity, okay? So this is on a non-stationary data, so you cannot do anything. Now let us see. Now what I did, now I made my data stationary. This is diff log air passengers. This is my stationary data. Okay. Everything is controlled. My variance is controlled. My mean is controlled. Now I'm running my ACF, that is auto correlation factor, on my stationary data. Now you can see. Okay. Now I get an output. This output you have to understand very, very carefully. Okay. Because from here I'm going to get my Q value. Okay, I'm going to get my Q value. How will I get my Q value? Okay, all these lines that you see, some lines are going are above this horizontal line, some are below this horizontal line. Okay, you have to count all of them. Okay, you, it's not like I have to count only the lines above it or below it. I have to consider both of them in sequence. Like if you have to start from zero, this is the zero line, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, this way. Understanding it? Okay, and my boundaries are these blue dotted lines. Okay, so I will have to consider only the lines within the blue dotted lines. The lines which are extending beyond the blue dotted lines are out of our scope. Getting my point? I will have to consider all the lines which are either above or below, immaterial of their position. Okay, are they above this horizontal line or below this horizontal line? Not a problem. I have to consider both. And how will I start counting from left to right? Starting from zero. Okay, like this line becomes my line number zero. This line becomes my line number one. This becomes 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. I hope you understood this counting part. Okay, this is counting. Now, which will be considered, which will not be considered? Count kaise karna hai, pata chal gaya. Now I have to understand which has to be considered, which has to be eliminated. All the lines falling within these blue dotted lines need to be considered. Okay, lines which are going out of these blue lines will not be considered. Like this line will not be considered. Even this line will not be considered. This line will not be considered. This will not be considered. No, this will also be not considered. Okay, is this part clear? Okay, now अब इससे हमें Q value मिलेगा. अब Q value कैसे मिलेगा? That is important. From this graph, I have to get my Q value. How will I get my Q value? Okay, you have to count the lines. How? The method is, I will start counting from 0, 1, 2. The first line which qualifies, the first line which I consider, the line number before that will be my Q value. जो लाइन पहला लाइन जो क्वालिफाई होगा उसके पहले वाला उसका प्रीवियस नंबर विल बी कंसिडर्ड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई स्टार्ट विथ जीरो, डिसक्वालिफाई, वन डिसक्वालिफाई, टू क्वालिफाई, टू से पहले द प्रीवियस लाइन बिफोर टू, वन, सो माई क्यू वैल्यू इज वन. क्लियर? समझ में आया? ओके, सो सिस्टम है कि आई विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, आई विल स्टार्ट काउंटिंग द लाइन्स, द लाइन विच गेट्स क्वालिफाइड फर्स्ट, ओके, द नंबर बिफोर दैट विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज क्यू वैल्यू. ठीक है? राइट. सो आई होप यू गॉट योर क्यू वैल्यू. इन दिस केस क्यू वैल्यू इज वन. Fine? Chalo. Now, next, I will have to find the p-value. Okay? P-value mein, I will not say ACF, I have to use PACF. PACF is partial autocorrelation factor. Okay? PACF is partial autocorrelation factor. Okay, so again the logic is same. I run it again, you have the same kind of an output. Start counting the lines. Can you tell me? You have to tell me what is the Q value now. Q value is 1. 2 is qualified. See, again, I think you are not getting the point. You have to start with 0. Zero, देखो, zero disqualify, one qualify, then zero, Q is zero. नहीं, okay, it has to be greater than, not greater than equal to. okay, it is just touching the line. Okay, fine. It appears like you do not have a package called XTS. You first install XTS, then install time series, T series. Chalo. Just make a note of all these. Once I complete this, I'll come to your installation part. Okay. देखो क्यू पी द मेथड इज सेम हाउ टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ओके ओनली थिंग इज पी वैल्यू कम्स फ्रॉम पार्शियल ऑटो कोरिलेशन फैक्टर एंड क्यू वैल्यू कम्स फ्रॉम ऑटो कोरिलेशन फैक्टर एसीएफ पीएसीएफ ठीक है एंड द डी पार्ट कम्स फ्रॉम नंबर ऑफ डिफरेंसिएशंस दैट टुक प्लेस ओके दिस इज द मोस्ट क्रूशियल पार्ट इन योर अरीमा मॉडल ओके क्योंकि बाकी सारी चीजें कुछ खुद से नहीं करनी पड़ती दिस इज द ओनली थिंग दैट आई हैव टू यूज माय जजमेंट रेस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स माय सॉफ्टवेयर विल रन ओके नाउ कम नाउ लेट अस सी इफ आई एम प्लॉटिंग दिस ओके प्लॉट द डिफरेंशिएशन वी नो दिस हैज गिवन अस आवर स्टेशनरी डेटा ठीक है Just this is our stationary data. Now let us see. Now focus here, focus. I'll get back. I'll come back again. Don't worry. Flow mein ek cheez seekho. I hope by now you have learned how to find P, D, Q. Okay. By now you have learned how to make your data stationary. At least ye do cheeze you have learned. Okay. Now pay attention. Because these two were the major building blocks. First, to make your data stationary. The second part was to make your the components of your ARIMA model, that is PDQ. Okay. So now you got it. Now we can easily create our model. Okay. Now let us see. I am giving a name fit. As I always tell, whenever I create a model, we have the habit of writing fit. Okay. Model of best fit. That's what we say. Okay. So fit straight away. The command is ARIMA. Okay. Straight away. The command is ARIMA. Now, I will write log air passengers. I did not write differentiation of logarithmic values of air passengers. I did not do that. Can anyone tell me why? See, this component 1, PDQ, this is PDQ. I have already included my differentiation here. Okay, so ARIMA model will differentiate it once automatically. When you are putting this PDQ, the D part is 1. Okay, so the ARIMA model will automatically differentiate the entire data once. So, fir se differentiate nahi karna hai. Okay, and remember, if at all I write diff over here, I will write 0 over here. Agar I write diff, okay, and put brackets, then in this PDQ part, I'll put a 0. In place of D, I'll put a 0. Okay. So, okay. So that is the point. So just the log of your data and then your PDQ. PDQ has to be put within the C, that is combine or concatenate. Okay. And your seasonality. This is again important. Your seasonality has always to be put in a list. Like you have various data structures. You have data frames, you have matrix, you have vectors. Your seasonality has to be in list only. So immaterial of what the data is, don't worry. Okay, data kaisa bhi hai, don't worry, list likh do. Okay, now put a list and order. Order will put things in an order. ओके ऑर्डर क्या होगा, पी डी क्यू, ऑर्डर इक्वल्स टू पी डी क्यू, ओके एंड व्हाट वाज आवर पीरियड, 12, मतलब यहां एक साल में 12, हम फोरकास्ट कर रहे हैं 10 साल का, लेकिन आवर फ्रीक्वेंसी इज 12, 12 महीने का, ओके सो फॉर 12 फॉर 10 इयर्स आई हैव टू रन द मॉडल 12 टाइम्स, ओके सो राइट नाउ आई एम प्रेडिक्टिंग फॉर 10 इयर्स, बट विद इन 10 इयर्स आई विल वॉन्ट टू हैव 12 different iterations for January, February, you know the frequency, right? So I'm keeping the period as 12. So this is my fit. Okay. If I just check what is my fit, I get some values, okay, which right now doesn't make much sense. Okay. If I see this, can you make much sense out of it? Coefficients, I have mal, small, one. Moving average 1, okay, and then you have moving average, another SMA, moving average 1, this is the error part, doesn't make any sense, okay, sense hai, lekin as such, as a layman, I can't understand anything, okay, so, next, I have to make the predictive analytics, I have to make predictions for 10 years, fine, so, very simple, I am creating a prediction model, so I say PRED equals to predict. I think in regression also we predicted, we use the same thing, predict. Okay, so predict, the model is fit. Kaun si model ko predict karna hai? Fit koi. Okay, so fit. And how many n ahead? Kitne periods aage jana hai? Okay, n ahead is 10 years into 12 months. Okay, n ahead means कितने आगे तक जाके you have to make the predictions. हाँ, 12 months करते करते 10 साल predict करो. Fine, so just I run it. ठीक है. Want to have a look at your predictions? हमने कर तो दिया, कुछ दिखा नहीं. So, would you like to have a look at the predictions? Obviously, you would like to have, right? Ki nahi? Yeah? Kahan dikh raha hai? Is command se toh sirf command run hua. And, haan, wahi bata raha hu ki usko, if I run this pred, okay, so it will give me the predictions. See? So, our data was only till 1960 December. Now you can see you have data from 1961 January till 1970 December. Okay, this is the prediction part. Okay. Theek hai? Now the best part or interesting part is the predictions that you got were in log forms, because you know we had already converted the data into log, so the output was also in logs, all the values are in decimals and they are in logs, okay, so I have to convert the log into decimal form, okay, the next step is converting your log values into decimal form, so simple way of converting your log values into decimal forms is multiply the log values with E value. We say E, okay? And E is 2.718. You multiply log values with E, you get the decimal values. And E value is nothing but 2.718. Okay? So I don't do anything, multiply will not power kar dena. Okay? So E to the power, your prediction, it will convert it into your decimal values. So I say prediction 1. I'm rounding it off also to zero decimal places because it is the number of passengers. I cannot have passengers in decimals. Okay. So I'm rounding off my passengers into zero decimal places. So 2.718 to the power prediction. Prediction may be there are two columns. If you see, one is predicted value and one is standard error. I don't have to do anything with the error. I have to just work on predicted values. Okay. The predicted values were in logs, log form. Usko I am converting it into decimal value, base 10. Okay, I am converting it. For which we have to take a power of e. Okay, e is 2.718. Okay, and I am rounding off to zero decimal place. So this gives me my prediction spread 1. Okay, now you can see this spread 1 is the predictions. Now you can see the kind of predictions I have. Okay, these are clean decimal numbers, no decimal values. Don't worry, I'll do it. I'll come again and I'll share you the file also. Okay, I'll share you the commands also. Abhi dekh lo, sun lo. Okay, now if you want to plot, okay, I'll plot the time series again. What I'm trying to do is I just want to extend my time series. The original time series that I had, the air passengers, I want to extend it. I have a prediction of 10 years ahead, right? So I want to make those 10 years connected with what I already have. So the simple way, now it won't be just plot, it will be TS plot, time series plot. Normally we simply write plot and continue. Now it will be TS plot. TS is time series plot. You have your air passengers, the original data, comma, your predicted data, pred 1, okay, and then we say log y, okay. Even without this, this would be constructed. It will just smoothen out things, and then this LTY equals to C1 comma 3. I'll come to this, okay. Even if you don't put this part, your graph will be plotted. But why I'm putting this, I'll come back in a short while. Okay. Now you can see I have a time series plotting. This dark line was up till the original data, and these dotted lines are the extension predicted values. Okay. And the last part that I'm left out, I have done my prediction. I just want to test my model, okay, whether my model is good enough or not good enough. Okay, what do I do now? Just see, I'm just creating another object. Let us say data wide. I have TS time series, air passengers, comma, frequency 12, start, end. Okay, just I'm creating a data. I'm creating an object. Okay, this is with the original data. Okay, now I'm creating another object that is fit the predicted model. Okay, Arima, the log of this, we have already done this. Okay, just that model. Now I'm creating the predictions, we have already done this. Okay, and I'm converting it into decimal. I'm rounding off the values. Okay, now you can see I've created the data 1, an object. Okay, data 1 is the object which contains the head of prediction 1. This is prediction. Okay, I'm just creating head. Head means upar ke 6 dekhna chahta hu, thode se values. Okay, I'm taking 12, the top 12, because 12 months. तो क्या होगा कि ऊपर के 12 महीने का किसी एक साल का ऊपर का टॉप, आई थिंक इट इज 1970 और समथिंग, नहीं 61 और मे बी, सो 61 के 12 महीने का डेटा, प्रेडिक्टेड डेटा निकाल के देगा. ओके, इफ आई वांट टू सी, दिस इज प्रेडिक्टेड वैल्यूज. ओके, एंड देन डेटा 2, आई एम क्रिएटिंग अनदर वन वेयर आई हैव द टेल ऑफ ओरिजिनल डेटा, द टेल ऑफ, नीचे के 12 निकालेगा और प्रेडिक्शन के ऊपर के 12 निकालेगा. ओके, एंड देन आई विल लाइक टू कंपेयर, उसका नीचे इसका ऊपर दोनों मैच होना चाहिए. जस्ट बराबर मींस फॉर 12 मंथ्स. क्या, हाँ, दिस इज द क्वेश्चन. ओके, नीचे का वैल्यू और प्रेडिक्टेड वैल्यू को ऊपर वाला क्यों मैच करना चाहिए? एज आई टोल्ड यू, वी आर डूइंग अ टाइम सीरीज एंड फॉर मी देयर इज ओनली वन independent variable, that is the previous year's data. So this year's data should be very similar to previous year's data. Make sense? I hope I have answered your question. Okay, so I'm creating another ठीक है, अब data 1 data 2 हो गया, ठीक है, just want to see what is data 1, this is prediction, and data 2 this is the original data. You can see prediction 419, previous data closed at 417, 399, 391, 466, 419, 454, 461, very similar, very very similar. Okay, and if you just want to see this visually, if I just want to see this visually, I just plot data 1, data 1 is my prediction, okay, data 1 is my prediction, and on which I want to impose the blue line which was the original data. You can see blue line is the original data, red line is the predicted data, both of them look very very similar. Okay, that is to say my model was very good model. Sorry, head of prediction, tail of the original. I hope you are getting the logic behind that. Okay, so this was the original thing I told you earlier also, in a time series. Okay, for me the best predictor value or the best independent variable I can say is the figures of the last year. Okay, so again if you want to just extend the original plot, you can just do it. This is the extension of the original plot. I'll come back to this. So